Vincent. I haven't seen you since, I unwillingly retired from my former post as head of security over at the Diamond Casino. I'd like to offer you a lucrative, albeit unorthodox, opportunity to make some money and sabotage one of your long-standing adversaries. If you're interested, meet me at the Vespucci police station.
You get a DWI in this town and you are fucked.
Like I care.
Wouldn't advise going inside. Not with your reputation for depravity and general aversion to the law, in all seriousness. Your countenance is quite discernible, and there are certain of my consociates who would take it upon themselves to exercise their right to lethal force were they to encounter you in person. But it's good to cross paths with you again, my friend. After head of security at the Diamond, this isn't exactly what I had in mind, but it's still a long way from a mall cop, right? Let's take a walk. Relax. I'm a cop, but I'm not a cop. This is just where the universe put me right now. I mean, I have my path and you have yours. And quite frankly, I don't give a damn about your antics out there. In fact, we may be able to assist each other. I mean, check this out. You see that misguided individual? How do you think he's gotten away with selling drugs in front of that burger shop very conspicuously for 10 years now? In front of the largest department in the city. He cuts them in.
Effenberger, you copy? Yo, Effenberger.
I copy.
Worst last name ever, dude. I mean, effing what? Anyway, when you got five, we all need some effing coffee down here on Dick's. And don't forget the effing cream and sugar.
Copy that. Oh, these motherfuckers. Huh? I'm out here getting coffee for cops on the take. And that guy over there is only a modicum of the issue. There's a new cartel running a large-scale cocaine operation out of the Cluck and Bell factory in Palito Bay. And be in no doubt, the cops, they're not only turning a blind eye, they're actively facilitating. If you ask me, the cartel and the cops can both go to hell, preferably on the back of the same bullet. I'm talking about a surgical strike, man. Taking out the whole operation. That's why I came to you. Let's go somewhere a bit more unfrequented. I understand your motivation in these matters. If you raid that factory, anything you find is yours to keep. But this isn't about the drugs for me. This is about these assholes running the biggest protection racket in the state. That's the kind of status quo I cannot abide. As far as my part, I can provide all the intel you need. Records, names, locations. We will need to educate ourselves on the factory, though. Gather materials so you can attack it with style and aptitude.
Ding fucking dong, Officer Effenberger. We're effing falling asleep over here. Get us some effing coffee.
Copy that. I'm on my way. Think about it. If anybody deserves to be fucked with, it's these guys. Can I count you in? Excellent. Now on to the first order of business. Acquire some funds. And fortuitously, we have files on some money laundering operations not far from here. The department allows them to operate for a share of the profits. I suggest we take a more proactive stance. Time to do what you do. I'll call you. Let me take these fucking assholes their coffee.
Yeah.
Hey, keep fucking with me, I'ma beat your ass. I'm gonna hurt you!
I got a bullet.
What the fuck are you?
One of our people needs help.
Help me.
I gotta reload, babe.
So while you're hard at work, allow me to explain some of the background to our endeavor. A few months ago, a new cartel arrived in San Andreas. They came up with a pretty smart plan to get the operation up and running. Pay key employees at Cluck and Bell to the day away while they use their distribution power to move large amounts of cocaine. The factory up in Palito Bay is pretty much a giant processing facility for the cartel. Every other Cluck and Bell van you see in town has a brick of coke under the mega mills. And of course, corrupt elements of the LSPD were only too eager to get cut in. Ingenious, right? But they think they got this whole thing sewn up, and that's where we come in.
Thank you.
Hey, it's me. That was a lucrative effort. This is a solid fund to use on the rest of our planning efforts, the first leg of which I'll get to work on right now. I'll be in touch. guy with the laptop. This is a critical piece of intel. The cartel have paid off multiple Clark and Bell employees to look the other way while they use their business as a cover for the manufacture and distribution of cocaine. This laptop's gonna give us a window into their schedules. I just sent you a CCTV image of the guy. You got a choice. Steal the laptop behind his back or incapacitate him first. I'll leave it to you.
Raise up now, motherfucker!
I don't like nobody playing on my phone.
You got eyes on him? Confiscate the laptop. This laptop is gonna tell us our optimal window for hitting the factory. Okay, with those two items taken care of, let's move on to the big one. The cartel occasionally takes train deliveries at the factory. We're gonna steal one of the trains they use and roll in right under their noses. But first things first, we're gonna need a set of keys if we're gonna board it unimpeded. From the LSPD. Just a simple matter of rerouting some calls.
What's up, fucking snatch?
schematics of the train signal network. Nope. Then just follow the instructions on the hacking device to change the signals as you approach them. You need to keep that train moving at all costs. If you miss your shot, the emergency brakes will kick in and you'll be sitting ducks. Progress update. The train you acquired has been discreetly relocated into storage, where it will remain until the day of the raid. Things are coming together. Next on the to-do list, acquiring weapons and gear, or the getaway vehicle. Your choice. So, we have some important yet enjoyable decisions to make. On the one hand, you need to acquire your preferred weapons and gear. On the other, you need to acquire your getaway vehicle. We'll need to steal both. These can't be traced back to us. Where would you like to start? All right then, stand by for your target locations. I'm sending you some visual ID of our targets. Make sure to familiarize yourself. As I'm sure you know, our operation requires weapons and gear that can't be traced back to us. The good news is that this city is crawling with gangs carrying that kind of contraband. Half of them in cahoots with this very police department. So today, we're gonna confiscate one cache of weapons and one stash of gear. If any of it ends up getting traced after our raid, it'll lead to these reprobates instead of us. I've sent you the coordinates of some appropriate targets. We don't need to hit them all. My advice is to investigate your options. Determine which gang is gonna have a loadout that suits your preferences, and prioritize accordingly. As I was saying earlier, we need weapons and we need equipment. That's armor and masks. We don't want anyone at the Cluck and Bell factory catching a glimpse of your own face. This group is more, how do I put it, small fry in the veritable ocean of felons we have here in Southern San Andreas.
Look at this dumbass motherfucker.
These individuals are not as established as the other targets on our list, so we shouldn't expect any serious trouble. Hunker down. They'll come after you hard now.
Everybody get back!
Something, huh? One of your rides? Let me know. I'll get there as soon as I can.
As I was saying earlier, we need weapons and we need equipment. That's armor and masks. We don't want anyone at the Cluck and Bell factory catching a glimpse of your memorable face. As I'm sure you know, our operation requires weapons and gear that can't be traced back to us. The good news is that this city is crawling with gangs carrying that kind of contraband. Half of them in cahoots with this very police department. So today, we're gonna confiscate one cache of weapons and one stash of gear. If any of it ends up getting traced after our raid, it'll lead to these reprobates instead of us. We've sent you the coordinates of some appropriate targets. You don't need to hit them all. My advice is to investigate your options. Determine which gang is gonna have a loadout that suits your preferences, and prioritize accordingly. This militia group's file is a lot thicker than the others. They're a formidable unit, talking high-powered, with meticulous security and military discipline. Do not underestimate them. They won't let any intrusion slide. Watch out! They know you're there! Be prepared to execute evasive maneuvers. You're making commendable progress. Once we grab weapons and gear, we'll have everything we need.
Guys, here!
Come on, we got this!
Back up!
Visual contact lost!
There should be both weapons and gear at these locations. Once you're satisfied, I strongly advise that you move everything to the locker. If you're feeling voracious, you can hit more than one gang and seize any extra equipment, whatever you get. We'll make sure it's available to you when we hit the factory. It's safe to say that any affected groups will be better prepared next time. Keep that in the back of your mind if you plan on coming back for a getaway car. good job. Now that you've secured all the weapons and gear necessary to take on a clucking bell factory overrun by the cartel, we should discuss your means of escape. Next up, acquiring a getaway vehicle. We need to take the same precautions we did for the weapons. We steal it from a gang, so the trail leads to them instead of us. Okay, possible getaway vehicles at these three locations. Sending surveillance footage of the gangs I found. Check them out. I'm sure you have plenty of vehicles capable of getting you out of Clucking Bell with all your extremities intact, but we need something that can't be traced to us. I've acquired three suitable options for a getaway car. All of them are sourced from local gangs bribing the LSPD to turn a blind eye to their activities. If the car ends up getting traced, the trail leads back to them, not us. We'll only need to use one of them for the raid. The choice is always yours.
Piece of shit!
Muere ya!
cocksucker!
Fuck! We got a man down!
You cocksucker! I'm out!
Excellent choice. We're not in any rush out there, so feel free to pay the other gangs a visit. And if you need their cars too, you want to be appropriately compensated for any extra vehicles you bring back. When you're ready to confirm your choice of vehicle, send me a message. This car should provide all the means necessary for a perfect escape. Now clear the area. We'll be in touch. Excellent. I've been investigating where the factory workers park, and fortunately for us, the garage seems to get completely ignored. Your getaway car will remain undisturbed until it's time for the raid. Hey, so I understand that your MO is up to you, but there are steps you can take to ensure the element of surprise is on your side. Introducing a little chaos into the cartel supply line is one of them. If you do, they'll assume your arrival on the train is just an unscheduled delivery. And if nothing else, the looks on their faces will be highly amusing. All right, you have the coordinates for the Clock and Bell outlet on Innocence Boulevard. I'll hit you with the brief en route. All right, the time has come to throw the cartel supply lines into disarray. We need them in a state of chaos. So when our unscheduled train delivery arrives at the factory, they just wave it through. So our primary objective is to locate their depot and sabotage their fleet of delivery trucks. Our secondary objective is to find a key card that'll allow us access to the factory's restricted areas. laptop, you got me? I found a schedule on it that says there should be delivery vans leaving this establishment any minute. Hang on, vans, and we can use the GPS to find the depot where they load up the drugs. That's where we're gonna hit them. We're getting our money's worth out of that guy's hacking device. Well, we're getting his money's worth. Before long, they'll know we've infiltrated their system, and they won't let it slide. This will be easy. Means the factory won't be expecting us at all. All you gotta do is sabotage the trucks and grab a key card. If you wipe the CCTV, they'll be none the wiser. But listen, if you wanna blow the trucks up, there's no way of keeping that on the down low. You'll be alerting the whole cartel that you're coming for them. But hey, maybe that's your style. Even in that getup, they'll still lose their cool if you're spotted wandering into the more sensitive parts of the building. You didn't hear from me, but if those guys know you're here, you gotta take them out. Otherwise, you risk the cartel hearing all about it.
Where you gonna go?
Go home, you fucking idiota. Lock your doors. Aquí estoy! Ain't nowhere to go, homie.
Infiltrate. Sounds like one of the guards informed the factory. They know you're coming.
Vamos!
Sometimes in the field, we meet the unexpected. And at that point, one must abandon all subtlety and get the job done. I pass no judgment for that. Though in this case, it does mean the cartel will be ready for you when you return for the raid. Hey, it's my pleasure to inform you that we have officially completed all necessary preparations to move forward with the Clucking Bell operation at your earliest convenience. Let's make this happen. It all culminates here, my friend. I've been on the radios, and after deciphering some mediocre code words, it sounds like they're expecting a robbery. I suggest you elegantly fuck their shit up, regardless. I'm sure it's hard not to focus on the guys trying to kill you, but remember, we're here for the operation, not the
people. Where you gonna go?
Acquire the cocaine, clear the safe, get the hell out. Don't forget the extra gear your crew procured. Feel free to experiment. It should be in a dumpster to the rear of the factory. You see, it pays to befriend your local garbage man.
Help him! Dale, puto! Look at my door!
¿Dónde eres, home? Where you from, mister?
The storage area should be where they keep their product. Take as much as you can. Don't forget to vacate the contents of the safe, too. Unless you want to find the key, head towards the office and do not cease fire. Be advised, shooting the handle could trigger further alarms. Establish a connection to the computer first.
I strongly advise you make your way to the ghetto.
that shit!
Solid choice for a getaway, if I do say so myself.
Hey, go back to where you came from, Holmes.
Okay, see that anybody chasing you is appropriately shaken, stirred, or otherwise dispatched. Whatever it takes to get you back to the lockup alone with the delivery crews. Stop ringing, the cartel and associated cops will process just how severely their operations been sabotaged. No cocaine, no cash, and nobody to blame. A less evolved part of me can't help but smile at the thought of them losing their collective shit. On the home stretch now, my friend. Soon you'll wash away the putrid scent of reconstituted meat slurry and finally enjoy the sweet smell of success. Excellent work. Mission accomplished. Now to the vital matter of payment. As I'm sure you can appreciate, there are certain transactions I can't be party to as an officer of the law. But if I've learned anything from my consociates on the LSPD, it's how to look the other way.
Now remember, as far as I'm concerned, you can hit that factory as often as you'd like. As long as you're giving me reasons to keep looking the other way, I'm happy. As you can see from my choice of transportation, my fortunes at the LSPD are also improving. Just got these babies in, fresh off the line. Guess who picked one up? Until next time, well, let's disassociate. To confirm that your compensation is in your account. And of course, to congratulate you again on a successful operation. Our efforts to derail the Clucking Bell cartel's efforts were indeed effective, but it won't be long before they and their corrupt counterparts in the LSPD rebuild their little enterprise. Each and every time we knock them back down, I'll ensure it's worth your while. Effenberger out. Hey,